You don't have to look too far beyond the front page of today's paper to know that we live in a dangerous world. But what is the worst that could happen? What does civilization's biggest threat look like? Would it crush our society? Would it destroy our values? Would there be any survivors? This is What If, and here's what would happen if a nuclear bomb went off in Washington, D.C. As the seat of American government and an emblem of Western democracy, Washington, D.C. is a natural target. With the White House, Congress, and the Supreme Court, a nuclear attack, however unlikely, would deal a crippling blow. Nuclear bombs come in a variety of sizes, the smallest being the Cold War-era Davy Crockett, which uses a 35-kilogram shell that could wipe out anyone in a 150-meter radius. It also lacked an abort feature. The largest nuke is Russia's Tsar Bomba, a behemoth with the power to instantly obliterate all of Paris. But in this scenario, the nuke that descends upon Washington, D.C. has a 10 kiloton yield, slightly less than Hiroshima's Little Boy, the first nuclear bomb ever deployed. A blinding flash of light and a city block instantly vanishes. In fact, any city block within 16 kilometers of the blast site would easily be reduced to rubble. An explosion of this size would propel broken glass as far as 5 kilometers in only 10 seconds. DC's power grid would immediately fail, and the bomb's electromagnetic pulse would render most cell phones and electronic devices within 3 kilometers completely useless. After a nuclear detonation, our human instinct may become our worst enemy. Many people would likely head towards the blast site, hoping to rescue or reunite with loved ones. Others would take to the roads, hoping to escape. But a concrete basement, not a car, is your best chance of survival. Upper atmospheric winds, which move much faster than anything we experience on the Earth's surface, would spread deadly radioactive dust far beyond the blast zone. The nuclear fallout could be traveling as fast as 160 kilometers per hour, if not faster. From 32 kilometers away, people would have roughly 20 minutes before harmful fallout would reach them. Depending on atmospheric conditions, fallout could come in the form of deadly sand, ash, or colored rain. Those who didn't find shelter soon after witnessing these effects would severely increase their chances of harmful radiation exposure and long-term cancer risk. With improved technology over the past few decades, the Integrated Public Alert and Warning System is capable of reaching the majority of those affected in the blast zone through a variety of channels. But evacuation would still be a logistical nightmare. Rescuers would first try to relocate people from the worst quality shelters. The evacuation would need to occur in several phases to avoid crowding, especially since most of the routes would be planned along sheltered passageways, places like subway tunnels and building lobbies. Complicating the challenge would be the fact that most of the first responders would be busy fighting the hundreds of fires that would be raging for several kilometers above the ground. For the first 5 days following the explosion, anyone within a 128 kilometer radius of the blast would need to remain behind adequate shelter to shield themselves from the likelihood of long-term radiation effects. While the agricultural industry in the northeastern United States would be jeopardized for some time, chances are the American economy would rebound quickly. After all, rebuilding the nation's capital will require a lot of manpower and billions of dollars. At the end of the day, a nuclear attack on Washington would be a devastating tragedy and carries the possibility of worldwide impact should the U.S. choose to retaliate. Whether they would or not, we'll leave that up to you. Comment below. Share your ideas, but don't forget to give peace a chance. See you next time on What If?